I don't understand it. I do and I don't. I understand why people have prejudice is always going to be around. And I think what gets on my nerves right now is probably white people trying to act a certain way in order to look less racist or look like this, that, and the other. It just comes off as fake. So when I tell you this story, that's not what I'm doing. My first best friend in Grand Prairie, Texas, in the little neighborhood that we lived in was Daniel. Daniel was a black kid, and I was a white kid, and it didn't matter. That's not what I remembered about Daniel. I just remembered I got along with him. He was nice, really nice. I remember one time I cut myself, and he brought me a Band-Aid, and we got to play with his brother's motorcycle helmet and stuff like that. We didn't care about any of this other stuff, and you learn that. And then I didn't realize that I had prejudice taught to me, not really developed, but taught to me, until I moved to middle school. And there were some people in my family that were prejudiced and against people of different color than we were. It may not just be black people, but anyway, it came from older people in the family. And then you go to middle school and you say some things because you're not used to being around different races, and you say something that's out of line. You don't even know it is. And you got a guy like Julian Finley who saw that I was just ignorant and didn't know any better. And instead of, you know, beating me down or making fun of me, you know, helped me and let me know that that wasn't cool in a kind way. And I remember even sixth grade, I still remember that kind of stuff. And none of that matters. And I also remember a phone call that I made when I was trying to get my first job as a minister, as a campus minister. I was looking for just about anything, and I was going to be a pulpit minister. And I called this congregation in Alabama and talking to this elder, and he was telling me, kind of giving me the pitch and selling to me all the things that were great about the area. And one of the things he pitched was private school. And my first question was, what's wrong with the public school? And he says, well, you know, there's a lot of, and he sort of whispered it on the phone, there's a lot of black people in the public schools. I thought, well, that interview's over. That conversation's over right there. How can you be a child of God? Know that none of this stuff matters, that nobody ever really knows what race a lot of people were in the Bible. Nobody really cares. The Bible didn't even mention what color Jesus was. None of that matters. All of these statuses that we make up and divide ourselves by don't matter. But to be partial, to have favorites, I'm not talking about individuals that we get along with. I'm talking about based on dumb things like race or like social status or economic status or whatever else, however you want to break it down. It just doesn't go. And James says that in James chapter 2 and verse 1, my brothers, show no partiality as you hold the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory. Romans 2 and verse 11 tells us that God doesn't play favorites. You can't bribe God. You learn that in Leviticus and Deuteronomy. He's not like that. He doesn't see. You learn when Samuel was going to pick the next king. It was David. It was the one that nobody even looked at. Samuel and his father Jesse didn't even present him, because David just didn't look the part. And you find out that God judges by here and not by the other things that we judge by. But it says here, you can't hold that faith and be partial like that and have prejudice like that. And we all do, and we all battle it, and that's just real. But you and I should be setting the standard here. And I know we wish the world would do this, that, and the other, but I have to do the best I can for me, and you got to do the best you can for you and try to impress that on other people and encourage other people. So he says, if you really, in verse 8, if you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, you shall love your neighbor. There's your clarification and specifics. Your neighbor as yourself, you're doing well. But if you show partiality, you're committing sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. I'd like to fix the world too, but it's not going to happen. You know, God's not even coming down here and fixing it. So I got to fix me and you have to fix you. Let's make sure that we're never, ever disregarding another human being on standards that God doesn't even use.